Good morning. Today we are going to talk about artificial intelligence. And this was written by Derek Bennett. Quickly, we're going to take a small background about the writer and who is Derek Bennett. And as you can see here, Derek Bennett has written stories and features for Bloomberg Business Week. And this was an American business magazine, and this was since 2010. In 2013, he was a finalist for the Grunold and Grunold Loop Award for magazine writing. He even writes about a broad range of topics, including sports, the airline industries, and robotics. In this article, Bennett focuses on the artificial intelligence, or the AI. In the past, high-functioning AI was a fascinating subject in science fiction, but today AI is becoming, or the artificial intelligence is becoming, very familiar part of everyday life. And inventions such as drones and self-driving vehicles rely on it. Yet complicated questions remain about this technology. In this article, as you can see, there is a robot that has been given a name, Dr. Phil. And Dr. Phil was created by the expert, or the artificial intelligence expert, Matthew Ginsberg. And Matthew Ginsberg created Dr. Phil to be able to solve the crossword puzzles and to participate in the crossword puzzles competitions. And this happened in Brooklyn in March 8 at the American Crossword Puzzle Competition in Brooklyn. So there's a very important question that has been asked in this article, and this is why computer can't joke. Okay, answering on this question, it is very, very important that some of the experts and researchers like Lawrence Maslach and Julia Taylor, his students, let's say that Lawrence Maslach is a researcher who's trying to make computer understand humor, and he is a computer science professor at the University of Cincinnati. And his familiar student, Julia Taylor, who is a professor at Buder. What they did is that they were trying to research for a way to make computers understand humor and to have sense of humor to make jokes. And as I have previously said, Dr. Phil, who is a game-playing program that has been created to play the crossword puzzle competition. A very, very important question is, computers don't joke, and why is it? Okay, and that is because they have no expectations to subvert. So as we know, you can expect anything from humans, but you cannot expect from computers. And that's why computers can't make a joke. Looking after that, Maslach, on the other hand, he is trying to program computers to have expectations and tease out meanings, to think, as he puts it, in a term of ontologies. But in my point of view, I see that this is impossible. So it is impossible for Maslach to reach to the point that to make computers think like humans. So there is a very important saying that Maslach said in this article, which is, if a computer can't come to understand what a joke and what is not a joke, then it is going to be able to think like a person. So this is something impossible, because computers is been programmed to do what they're said to do, but they cannot create or think out of the box. They cannot think more than they have been programmed to. So in a very short summary, we can say that there is a huge comparison between human intelligence and artificial intelligence, Whereas when there is an action is been done, or if you are put in a certain situation, you can think to try to solve this problem or to get yourself out of this situation in somehow by creating your own way of thinking. But computers, they cannot do so. If they're not programmed to do what they're supposed to do, they cannot think more than that. So we can say that computers have limited thinking, whereas humans have unlimited thinking. So this is the summary of this text, or of this article. Let's look at some of the vocabularies that have been mentioned in this text. One of them is called unorthodox, and it means to different from the normal or the typical style. And as you can see here, an orthodox is an adjective. So another vocabulary has been mentioned is buns. And what's the meaning of buns is called, it means humorous uses of words involving different meaning of the same word or words that sound alike. And buns is a noun, so we should take care of this. Buns is a noun, it's not an adjective. Another vocabulary that has been mentioned in this article is subvert, and it means to defeat or overcome or reverse something. So here, this is called subvert. As we can see here, computers cannot subvert because they don't have expectation. So subvert is a verb here. Let's look at for the other vocabulary. The next vocabulary is called unintentional. Unintentional means not done on purpose. So when you do something accidentally and you don't mean to do so, this is called unintentionally. And unintentional here is an adjective. And finally, the last vocab that has been mentioned in this article is domains. And domain here means, or domains means, areas of comprehensions or expertise. And domains here is a noun. Okay, so this is the first, this is the text called Artificial Intelligence, and this is the summary of the text. Thank you. See you next time.